Happy holidays, ladies and gentlemen. It is the Scuff Gaming Showdown. Mr. X, Puckett, bringing you action. And we have a nice little Christmas theme.
Yeah.
Matching our Christmas tree.
Absolutely.
With this gorgeous
green.
Green, semi-lime green background.
Right. We don't have much
George.
Red.
One day.
Red, yeah. Next Christmas.
We tried the red and it looked pink, so we just went pure green. Anyways, there's an important match going on right now, and FaZe is up 2-0 over TK in it. 45 seconds till the action begins here on Freight. And let's show you this map a little bit and what's about to go down. It's Blitz.
I'm going to show you a little free cam here, Puckett. You know, I think the
Is your free cam better than my free cam?
Oh, well, you know, mine's a little better color. But I think this area of the map right here, this cargo area, is definitely one of the most important areas to control on the map. If you can get that control from the side that TK is currently on, you're able to get up into here, shoot out this little door, and you're able to get into that top bar room right above the – that would be the FaZe goal. Get some easy caps that way. And if you are FaZe, you definitely want to get control over your cargo. And also, you want to open up this fire door right here, which I believe TK will close, and also the front door right here in front of the TK goal.
So, TK, need to shut the door.
Yeah.
And seal the deal.
Right.
All right, we're getting into the action. Let's jump on board with Sharp and see if he goes directly for that door like you called out. And yes, Mr. X, you may be the smartest man in Call of Duty history.
I may possibly be the smartest man in Call of Duty history.
By the way, I made you look good with that Sharp switch. Anyway, we got Neslo picking up first blood, but Classic will answer right back. TK, they need to catch up. Down 2-0.
Yeah.
Now it gets scary. When you're playing a best of seven, it's going to be the first of four. And you really can't give your opponent any momentum. Clayster trying to take that momentum right back. Gets one shut down at the base, unable to get in for a second kill. But here comes Theory, and that will be the first point for TK. The score tied 1-1. Nice defense from Theory as he swaps back to his base as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, a lot of the teams, I mean, you're seeing it from both teams right here that they're running four submachine guns. And that's what I love about Freight Blitz. It's so fast-paced that you're able to just get constant just craziness and just gun battles, Puckett.
Now, when people were watching Columbus, they saw like Karma get up top and he went on like a 17 kill streak from the second level with a Remington. Do you think that strategy isn't necessary on this map? Because it looks pretty comfortable if you're just rocking an MTAR with the sprint button held down.
Yeah, and this map you definitely want that MTAR and you want to hold your sprint button forward and you really want to be putting the pressure on. And if you're able to get to the other team's base, I mean, look at Classic right now. He's going to just try and open up the doors. And it's all about aggression, Blitz, Puckett. If you can keep that pressure on the other team's spawn, you will win Blitz consistently.
You know, I have Lennox switch right back over to Theory because already he's capped three times on a 5-1 spree at the moment. So one death to his 5 kills. Another kill here at the base. That was number 6 as he gets in for his 4th cap. This man is running laps. We saw Rambo do this back when Envy played at Columbus, in Theory, definitely taking on that objective role for his squad, and his teammates are scoring as well. That one was Neslo going in as Clayster is currently 7-4.
Yeah, and you know, that's surprising because you usually see Neslo, he's the more objective-minded player for this 2K lineup. And I mean, but Theory is a player, he's kind of like Aches in a way that he can do a little bit of everything. He can run a submachine gun, he can run an AR, he can slay, he can do objective work, and he's just one of the strongest overall players. You know, he really doesn't have a weakness.
Sharp coming alive as well. It's going to open up that front door to the bar area, as we'll call it. Some beer down, and will Sharp be able to get in? No, he's cut down from behind. Let's go back over to Clayster, currently 7-5. And what is Clayster rocking here? Is he also going MTAR for the time
being? Yeah, Clayster's also rocking a submachine gun. You know, he used to like doing this for us more with the Vector than the MTAR. But, you know, Clayster also has a very good submachine gun. But, you know, right now,
there's
Classic
one player
is
11-3,
man. He is a monster. He went off at Columbus, but you both said he surprised both of us.
Yeah, if you look at, we're going to stay on board with Classic. And why? Yeah. Well, he has more than all of his teammates combined.
Yeah.
Replays with 2 kills. Cap at 2 kills. 4 for Methods. Classic with 11 all by himself. Make it 12 after that one. 12-4 with 1 cap. However, his teammates are focused on the captures. And you just saw on the scoreboard, Replays got in. Now it's Methods. Actually playing some base D laying down. He gets taken out. Will they score? Yes, they do. Over on the opposite side, that was Neslo going through, I believe.
Yeah, and I mean, the TK is just really just putting on a very good show in the Blitz. They know they're down 2 maps in the series. They needed this map. And it's all about pressure, Puck. I mean, like you said, Classic has more kills than his entire team combined. You're not going to win the game like that.
Now Glaze is starting to heat up as well. 13 and 8. Wasn't able to pick up number 14 to secure that cap. We're going back over to Neslo. Sharp also pushing forward. You can see it on the mini map in the upper left-hand corner. Big kill there from Neslo. His opponent looking for him. Neslo goes up and above. I love this play. Look at the push from Neslo, and he's in.
Yeah, and I mean, that's just a great route right there from Neslo. We see Crimson6 loves to use that route as well. And I mean, right now, I mean, there's really not much to say. You know, the TK is just dominating.
12-3, brother.
Yeah.
They were down 2-0 entering game number 3 here on Blitz. And Neslo says, boys, we're not slowing down. Theory opens it up with 4 straight caps. Now Neslo and Clayster turning it on. Here's another one from Neslo. Gets one and gets in. 13-3 with 22 seconds still left on the clock.
Yeah, you know, this phase lineup, they just don't look comfortable at all with this game mode. I mean, you see the kills. It is just not good. I mean, JCap 3-14. Replay 6-12. Methods okay at 8-13 just because everybody else is not doing as good at all.
And Sharp got in as well there.
That's,
so Sharp 4 caps. Neslo 4 caps. 6 from Theory. Clayster was the defensive man at 14-10. On the other side, JCap getting crapped on 3-15, 6-13 from replays, and Methods at 8-13. I apologize for using the offensive language on a holiday, but that's the only way
I
can
describe
that performance.
Yeah, that's the only way you can describe that. I mean,
can we watch JCap in the second half?
Yeah, let's watch JCap in the second half.
What's going wrong for this man?
Yeah, let's see. I mean, you know, JCap, like we said earlier, he's mostly in AR, and Blitz is such a fast-paced game mode that, you know, sometimes it gets a little too chaotic for people. And right now, it doesn't look like he has quick draw on this battle. A little bit crazy.
And there's number 4, so already we're bringing him good luck. Number 5, all right. Tide is turning here for JCap. 2 straight kills.
One more kill, and he matches the whole
first half. And there we
go. Matches the whole first half in the first 30 seconds of the game.
All right, so JCap's back into it. His teammate replays just went in, so they're starting to put up points, but they're down 10. So if you're phased, you're down 10 points, 4 minutes, 20 seconds left on the clock. What is the team's strategy? What's going on with their communication right now?
Right now, I mean, you have to play aggressive. There's no opportunity to kind of sit back and play defense. You need caps. You'd be willing to give up a single cap for maybe 2 or 3 at this point. So, I mean, they need to push up as a team. Your Classic's able to get one, so that's a great play out of him. You know, you're just running down the lead slowly.
And they do have 3 players at their base. So they got to fight out of this pickup, too. Do they see the player in the back? Classic's going to double back for the kill. Great defensive stand here from FaZe, but they got to keep pushing forward. They got to keep the pressure going, and that is another big kill. That time, JCap. JCap coming alive in the second half. Classic continuing to lead the squad, though. That is his 18th kill. 18-12 with 2 caps going in for number 3 right now. No players to beat. His teammates have them distracted. Easy kill for Classic, but he wants the kills as well.
Yeah.
What a job here from FaZe Classic.
I mean, this is just, he's really impressive. I think the people who haven't seen him before, they need to just watch more of this guy's gameplay. He's killed everything on the map. A ton of objective work. And he's definitely one of the top 10 players on Ghost right now, man.
Top 10. The strong words, man, from Mr. X. I'm liking it.
I mean, I've seen he's good.
He puts it down from when I watch, man. He's putting up some numbers. 19-13, the most kills in the game. Tying Clayster, actually, with the exact same KD. For the moment, though, you're watching replays, and replays is going to double back, trying to dodge one opponent in the back. Gets a kill. 2 more players protecting that blitz spawn. He won't be able to get in, but JCap, actually, I thought he had a chance. No, he's coming way off the respawn on the opposite side. Let's go back to Classic to see what this man can do.
Yeah, you know, I think Classic is actually on spawn, so I'm actually on board with the TK guys, but you know, 2 of them are taken out, and let's see if Replay is going to push this white, and I like this play out of Replay. He's forcing that back right spawn.
They got to go. Doing some work. My players be dead. We're going over to JCap again.
Yeah, your players are all dead, but I mean, it looks like there's the player from TK who's going to sneak by, and that is Sharp. But he's taken out, so you know, you're seeing that, you know, a little bit of a comeback out of this phase lineup.
Theory on your screen for the moment here from TK.
He's got to get these doors closed.
And what was the score at the half? Was TK at 13?
I think it was 14-3, I think.
14-3.
So I think they've gotten one since the start. They traded one at the beginning, but ever since then, all FaZe.
So FaZe trying to stay hot. Remember, Methods had the hot hand in the first two games. So far, the only player positive is Classic. And TK starting to get that momentum again. Neslo now 22-13.
Yeah, and I mean, you know, you saw he's in the back of Montgomery. Replays picks up two huge kills on his goal right there, and that's huge. That would have been another cap for TK. And if you're FaZe, it's a minute and 15 left. You can't afford to trade caps. You need to push. They need to actually score within this 10 seconds, Bucket.
Yeah, if not, you know, it takes 10 seconds for that timer to count down.
Right there.
I think it's mathematic. It's going to be tough. Replays is in the base. Couldn't get the second cap in. Methods goes down inside as well. We're on board with J-Cap as he's going to be trying to push up on this left side. But Blitz, so far, it has all gone in TK's favor. They had an enormous first half, giving them a huge lead going into the last 5 minutes. And TK, they're going to continue to put the pressure all the way to the end. Theory on your screen at the moment.
Ooh, he's going to get shut down in the base by Replays. But you see Neslo and Sharp, they're going to try and run around the back. Sharp picks up one. Neslo knows there's another guy in the goal. But look at the mini-map. You can see his three teammates all around there.
And FaZe Classic looking for his 22nd kill. Currently even at 21-21 with four captures. And he will not be able to beat that opponent. Nah. Will get killed at the base as they go through for number 20 on the TK side. Replays is going to clean it up, but it's too late. What a job here from TK after a losing Search and Destroy, after losing Domination. Yeah. They are able to take Blitz in convincing fashion.
Yeah, I mean, that was a strong game out of the guys from TK, you know. And you saw in the second half, they stopped being a little aggressive at the start. They should have just kept the pressure up. But, you know, they were able to hold on to that lead. You know, I did like what I saw from FaZe in the second half. It was much better played than the first half. They were more aggressive, and they looked – they just got more map control. Pretty much they picked up a lot more kills, too.
28-16 from Neslo, doing a lot of that slaying with five captures of his own. So, solid stuff. You know, we were following Methods for the first two games. He finally has a rough one on Blitz. Yeah. I think Neslo was the shining player in that one. You also had Theory put up positive six with seven captures and Sharp plus four with seven caps of his own. So
yeah, I mean, both players went off. I mean, Theory with those 23 kills, 17 deaths, and seven captures. I mean, that's a great game for Blitz.
Who's your MVP on that one?
I'm going to say Theory. You know, he started off that first half pretty strong. I mean, he got a ton of caps.
The momentum, man.
Yeah, that just kind of threw the whole game in TK's favor, so I would say Theory.
I'm not going to disagree with you. Guys, we're going to a quick commercial break. The score now 2 to FaZe, 1 to TK. Can TK tie it up? We're going back to Domination. The map is going to be Strike
Zone.
Yeah, you wrote Strike Down. I got really confused. It's like, that's not even a map. Yeah, we're going to go to Strike Zone. We'll be back with more Dom after this. Mr. X can write well.